we're asked to simplify d times 4d to the 1/2 power. So let's see what we can do here. And I think there's multiple ways to kind of simplify it, and we'll explore all of them. So d times 4d to the 1/2, 4d to the 1/2, let me just focus on that right there. 4d to the 1/2, if you take the product of two things and you raise that to an exponent, that's the same thing as taking each of those terms to that exponent and then taking the product. So 4d to the 1/2 is the same thing as 4 to the 1/2 times d to the 1/2. And of course, you have this d out front. This d out front. And I could put the parentheses here, but it doesn't matter at this point. Now you just have three things that you're taking the product of. So I'll put this d out front just like that. And now there's a couple of ways you could think about it. You have this 4 to the 1/2 power, and you're taking its principal square root, so it's positive square root. So that right there is going to be 2. So 4 to the 1/2, that right there is going to be equal to 2. And then there's a couple of ways you could think about it. You have this d out front. You have the d out front, and then you have a d to the 1/2. And then you have a d to the 1/2. And there are several ways that you can now represent this depending on what you feel, I don't know, what aesthetically pleasant. You could say, well, look, this is d to the first power. This is d to the 1/2 power. I could add them. So you could say that this is, so one way to say it is it's 2 times d to the 1 plus 1/2. You could either say 1/2 power or 3/2 power if you want. So that's one simplification of this expression. Another simplification would be, well, you could say, look, d to the 1/2, that is the same thing as the square root of d. So you could say this is the same thing as 2 times d times the square root of d. So any of these are actual simplifications, but it's interesting to see that they're really all representing the same thing.